Deborah will be speaking about Valdemecca and about Distinguished Toastmaster.
Thank you, Carol. And good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and honored guests. It is with great pleasure and pride that I'm here today to present Valdemecca with her DTM medallion, Distinguished Toastmaster Medallion. And many of you know this is quite an accomplishment. Fewer than 1% of all Toastmasters worldwide achieve this distinction, hit this milestone. It's really something. To get there, Valerie had to complete 45 speeches, do leadership projects, and mentor new club, which she did here. She served as a leader in the district as area director last year. So she's touched a lot of people's lives through this journey of hers with Toastmasters. I'm so pleased to be a part of that journey and to have gotten to know Valerie. Achieving the DTM requires persistence, dedication, commitment, and Valerie always did it with a great deal of enthusiasm. And that's transferred to everything that she's touched. It's great to achieve the DTM award, and I'm very pleased to present it to Valerie. I do want to say that a lot of Toastmasters, is not what we do with Toastmasters though, in Toastmasters, it's how we use it in the world. And I know that Valerie's, this has opened a lot of doors for Valerie, and I'm sure it will open very many doors in years to come, and I will and touch many lives. So I'm very honored today to present Valerie. Please join me. Present you with this medallion. And it has the date of her achievement. What I do want to say too is that some of us, it took 10 years to get to this level. And Valerie did this in 4 years. So please, a round of applause. Congratulations. And can we have a standing ovation for Valerie?
I like to put in a change order. They should put a little Velcro. Exactly right. This, it's not the medal, it's not the award, it's the lives you touch, it's the people that you see where you came from. So for me, it was fear of public speaking. So what is fear? It's false evidence appearing real. It's not real, but if a person believes that it's real to them. And I decided in 2013, when I worked for the state controller, I'll join Treasury Toastmasters. But I had limitations. It was narrow and small. And I was only looking to be a better public speaker. That's it, nothing more. So don't ask me to be a DTM, and don't ask me to do a contest, and don't ask me for anything. It's all about my self-development. Well, that changed because I had limitations, but God had no limitations for me. So as my heart started changing because of the various people that would come up to me and say, wow, you gave this speech and it really impacted me. That was my heart's desire, because it's about sharing the lessons and experiences that I had with others so that maybe it would be able to help them not have to deal with heartache or things that I went through. That was the motivation. Then we have time for who wants to be an officer? Well, I hid behind a little invisible cardboard thinking that I'm not doing it. But once again, I hear God say, why don't you take a chance? Instead of being the same people and the officers mix around into different roles, why don't you do it? All right, what role would be best suited that it would not be over the top because I'm still working? Okay, which one could I do? All right, I'll be the VP of Public Relations. Well, that was just a desire because the club was helping me change. So why not tell other people about it? I'm experiencing the change. Let's do it. Deneen is the area director at the time, and she comes to Treasury Toastmasters. The two times she comes to the club, who's giving a speech? Me. Now, I did not want to give a speech in front of Deneen because Deneen's the area director. She's thinking, oh, she's like a big boss, and oh, how can I give a speech in front of her? Deneen comes over to me afterwards and she says, you know, the two times that I was at this club, you were giving speeches. So it seems like you should be moving forward. If you do this, this, and this, you can try to get this award. And if you do that, that, and that, then you can do this award. So she would put these little seeds in my mind. And I was like, okay. And then time went by. And then I would hear her voice and she would say, you know, if you just do this, you're this close, just a little bit more. Now it's the whammy. She says, oh, can I recommend you as area director? Well, Deneen, what's required of me? I was on the phone with her at least an hour. And I'm taking notes, what's required? Because the way that I do business is, if I'm not just gonna say yes unless I know that I can actually do it. Because why would I say yes and then try to let people down? And that was really the best thing that I've ever done, because I got to meet people in 6 different clubs, 142 people, and to hear speeches and attend some of their club events, it was just amazing. And I learned from them as well as them learning from me. I got out and did contests, which was excellent, and that's what our club encourages our members to do, because it's these little steps of faith, it's these little milestones that gets a person out of their comfort zone. And it's not like, all right, you're gonna start walking one day and then you're gonna be running in a marathon or triathlon. What it is, it's one step of faith at a time. And as you take that one step of faith, now you start to get comfortable in the area you're in. Now, okay, the desire to, all right, I'm getting like stagnant here, let me take another step. And then as you take that next step, it just keeps going and going and going. And then it's at the point where, wow, I was able to actually finish the program. And I had no idea that such a small percentage actually finished. But I had great role models. I had Deborah, who came alongside me when I met her at an officer's training. And I said, I'm thinking of chartering a club here at NJOIT. She said, I will help you without hesitation, without anything. Deneen, she came here and she was supportive with the club as well. She helped me when it was time to run area contests, getting 6 clubs together and have people compete in a contest. She sent me the material and the templates that I needed, and she was there to help me and support me. Basically, what Toastmasters is takes a person out of their comfort zone, and if they're willing to do it, there will be people alongside to help mentor you and help you grow. And it's just like a gym membership. You can go and pay, but what you put in is what you will get out of it. So as you can tell, I have strong muscles in my Toastmasters arena. And it has been really an amazing experience, incredible people. I'm so grateful for the opportunity. I've had support not only from the club, from other clubs, from my family and all that. And it all is truly because of God helping me and His grace, which is more than enough. And
Valerie's presence in my life, I wouldn't know any of you probably. And maybe I'd know you to say hi in the elevator. I wouldn't know your name. So, with few exceptions, the people that I cherish the most here at work are the people that I've met through Toastmasters, and I'm very, very grateful for that. One of those people is about to come up here, Sharon Pagano. She's going to be our